So this is a demo of getting a paper's information formatted into an Excel file for uploading into Magic, part two. So at the end of part one, I was trying to figure out how the unoriented samples were oriented, and the method that they used was described in the supplemental material. Said that it was corrected by assuming that the GAD field was zero, and then they correct everything was oriented in the same direction at least, and then they corrected it by 146 degrees. So we're going to use the decorrected for the D values, and use a method code to describe that. So I'll go back to our spreadsheets here. Here's a spreadsheet from the paper. Here's a spreadsheet we're using. So for the method codes for the first core, we're going to do a sample orientation dash GAD. That means it's corrected by the GAD field. And then that down here, and then for the rest of them, I will put SO dash mag because they use the magnetic compass for the orientation. Oops. Okay. So that's good for now. Next, we'll fill in the geologic classes. So it's going to be a flow stone. Oh no, classes. Sedimentary. And aqueous from the last one. And actually, I've added flow stone to our lithologies now, so I'll change this. Sites. Geologic types. Look back here to the vocabulary list. Okay. Look at the data model. Poland eliminated list of sample material types. Okay. Ah, yes. Let's look at those. So, vocab lists. Textures there. Sample material types. And we'll call this sediment layer. We'll use sediment layer for now. Seems like the best one. There probably should be some kind of flowstone here, but there isn't. Vitrified stone. Edit. Paste special text. Okay. Let long, it's gonna be the same. Now, what we would like to do for the age is use the data model information to fill out the age for each of these sites. So let's go back to that. Ages. Okay, and we don't have an extrapolation, so thorium. Here we go. So for RMDI RE1. This core has the ages. So easiest way is maybe by the depth. So let's look here. Maybe we're going to add, let's see, site. We have the depth. Let's check it out. Go to the data model, go to sites. Core depth, perfect, in meters. So we don't, they have it in millimeters. So let's go over here, look at the original. original. Depth in millimeters. So what do we want over here? Core underscore depth. Let's add that in here. Underscore depth. I'll unbold it just for clarity. That's not required. Then copy this. Copy core depth, paste it in here. Actually, we need to multiply it or divide it by 1,000, so we'll make a new column. Here, let's say this equals this divided by 1,000. Okay, and now we can use this core depth with the age model, hopefully. You sussed out. Depth, 8 millimeters. Interesting. Doesn't match up. Okay, because they put this took the samples out there. So to get something close, we'll do it at 9. Age. Paste. Unit. KA. Okay, and the next one. So you can see how to do that, and I'm going to stop here and fill those in and then continue.